Hi guys, my name is Isabella Green, and today I would like to share with you what I know about entering multidimensional space through intimacy. This is for those who are already on the level where their third eyes are activated, for those who have traveled space in their visions, and those who can do this consciously, those who can do lucid dreaming consciously, and those who are also able to navigate themselves through multidimensional space, through planets, through dimensions, through multiverse, through the infinite field of possibilities in meditations. If you're on that level, this video would be great for you. And if you're not, then you could take notes for yourselves. And if you're not able to get there yet, then, you know, perhaps this would pave the way for your future awareness or your future abilities. We all know, we all heard that sexuality is the entryway to spiritual experiences, right? We know that, we heard that before. Those of us who have evolved past the body friction type of sexuality now seek in what's called sacred sexuality. I am here to share with you that it is possible to travel dimensions and to discover each other in the multidimensional space when you utilize that sexual energy that's available to you both. I have observed that if two people don't move into the space of actual sex immediately, but if they connect first, and we start from connecting heart centers and then the third eye centers. I recommend putting your heads together and connecting the third eye, placing your left palm on your partner's chest and connecting that way. And you can also sit in the tantric position where you are cross-legged, but you're really connected in the lower centers as well in that way. That's not really necessary. I've observed that I personally prefer to be on my knees and to have physical, like all of the centers in the body touching physically while you have your third eyes connected. I also find that holding hands at that point is really helpful as well. Helps me because once I start departing from my body, I'm holding on to that person, holding on to his hands, and that really helps. I recommend first connecting with each other and really finding that heart space, and also start the body vehicle, start allowing it to get turned on, but not turned on to the point that you are unable to hold your sex drive and everything just drops into the lower centers. Stimulating that connection and that just tingling that whole space around intimate connecting first, and then maybe getting into that position. And again, I recommend being on the knees, have with the bodies touching and the third eyes touching, holding the hands, and then moving that energy. You're going to feel, you know, your energy follows your attention. Where you move your attention is where your energy goes, right? So I don't really believe that we need to know any specific wild technique here. We just need to bring our focused attention to the first center, to the lower parts of our bodies where we are at that moment feeling each other's presence, right? And move that energy. You can take a deep breath, just visualizing that breath starting from your first center, moving up your spine to your third eye and focusing that energy. You take a deep breath from your lower centers together and bring that energy right into your third eye when you're already connected in that physical space. Of course, you know, we don't really need to even be connected in the physical space, but I find that it's helpful, you know, for the body, for the mind, that you have that physical touch of your third eyes right there going on. And so once you pull that energy, you will feel it. Both of you would feel it. Very often, I know that people would start having like cringes, you know, like those, like that kind of motion, because the energy is moving. That's a very powerful energy when you are sexually aroused, but you're not going down with energy. You're moving that energy up. You're pulling that energy up. Then, the energy centers in your body are going to get stimulated, and you might get like those like little wobbling movements or strange movements in the body. And then you literally bring in the intent focused attention into the third eye space together, right? And then if you decide, you can take another one of those deep breath with an intention of like, ooh, let's just get out of our bodies altogether, while you're holding on to each other and standing up like that on in front of each other. That will like support you while you're on your knees, and holding on to each other's hands, that would support you too, and holding the heads together, that would support you from like falling over once that energetic form starts moving out of your physical forms. And I've observed that visions start happening. I move into that space really quickly with the right partner, with the person who has high frequency, and also with someone who is very heart-centered. If that's the person who really cares about you, really loves you, and you feel the same for them, you experience in that first level of love. And pay attention here, I'm saying the first level of love, because we're going to talk about the second and the higher level of love that comes in during this experience that I'm sharing. But the first level of love you experience for each other, and you have that physical openness and the physical draw to each other, and you move that focused attention, your focused energy through your body into the third eye space. And from the third eye space, you just have to have, if your third eye is already open, you just have to have intention like, oh, let's go fly, let's go travel space, let's go travel dimensions together. And I may, on the second breath that you do together, I'm normally already like, you start seeing, or I start seeing like flying through wormholes, you know, flying through space. Very often it's just like you just like start seeing stars flying by, like you're moving through that dark space. It's also possible that you would observe yourself in front of a wormhole entrance, like the entrance to the wormhole. I saw that recently, and it looked like the space of, if you take oil, black oil, like the actual oil from Earth, and drop a pebble into it or a large stone into it, it would create that kind of like, wah, like the circles, right? Like not water, because water is like too much ripple, like the slower ripple effect. So I was looking at that, but it's flat. It's like not flat, but it's in front of me. It's vertical like that in front of me. And it's got like stars being sucked into it, and I'm like, wah, just like stop right in front of it. And I know that my partner is right next to me, right there. And I'm able to speak in that space, and I said, "Hey, we're entering the wormhole," and he was like, "I can see it, I can feel it, like I can feel the pull, like being pulled into it." And so, okay, so we take another breath like that from the lower centers, power that rocket, power that vessel that's about to go through the wormhole with your own kundalini, with your own sexual energy. Just take that breath back in, you off you go. You go through that wormhole. And so we went through that wormhole and came out on the other side, where all of a sudden I'm seeing this magnificent planet. It's a whole different reality. It literally just went like into that space, and it was like an hourglass shaped, right? So it went, I we went into that circular entrance. And like on the other end of it, when it opened up, it just opened up into a whole different reality, the whole different space. And so I'm seeing this incredible otherworldly, otherplanetly beach-like, you know, thing, where beings are floating around, and they're not, you don't really see them. They're not really beings. They're just like bubbles of like soap bubbles, like transparent energetic forms, and they're merging and they're floating in and out of each other, and everything is made of that same thing. And so I speak, you know, because I want to see if my partner is there with me, and so I start to speak and I start to describe that space. And he says, oh, I'm not really seeing it, because I'm very visual. I'm actually literally seeing the colors, and I'm seeing like additional planets and in the sky there, and everything is just like bluish pinkish kind of color, and reminded me kind of that Valerian movie where they're in the space of pearl, but like different, similar to that, just to give you an idea. And he says, I can sense all that. I'm not really seeing it, but I can sense that the sand that we're looking at, sand, you know, is made out of the same kind of bubbles. They're just like energetic forms that create any type of form. Those are energy beings that create any, it's like united consciousness of that space, of that planet. And everything is made out of that same consciousness, just different shapes and different sizes. And so I get all excited and I zoom in and I can see that the sand is literally the same type of beings that are also us at that same moment, right? But the sand is made out of that same type of fabric of reality. And so we float, me and my partner, we float farther in, and I'm guiding that. I'm saying, oh, I'm seeing this. And he's like, yeah, I'm totally seeing the same thing. And so then we move into that space where there's like a structure, and it's made out of that same fabric too. So we spend some time there, and then you do another breath, you know, you literally like pull yourself and be like, let's go next place, we've explored this place already, so let's go to another one. And you literally, like, at that point when you've already gone through the wormhole, you literally can just like quantum jump. You literally be like, boop, and you're into the whole next reality. And so we did that, took another breath here, you know, because we need the energy, we need the rocket fuel. So we pulled that, and then we jumped into a different reality and a different reality. And at some point, I can do too many, because I really literally faint, you know. So I usually do maybe 3 or 4 jumps like that, and then and then that's it for me. And so at the end there, I'm seeing him in front of me. We are on the craft, and I'm seeing him in front of me, and I know it's him. Well, he was with me the whole entire time, right? We had wings that we were flying over the space, then we were like on the desolate planet, then we were on this beautiful planet, and he was like, yeah, I'm seeing this. I'm like, you have wings, I have wings, and it's just like sharing that whole thing. Well, we're like barely able to speak here to like guide each other where we're going. And so at the end, I'm seeing him on the planet, on the craft, and I'm seeing his form, and it's a non-human form. And in my third eye, through my that space that where I'm looking at him, I'm recognizing him fully, and I feel that unity of that consciousness. Like I can fully experience his state of being, who he is, and his soul, and all of these forms that we just saw and we just experienced together. We know that we were linked through in these spaces as well, right? And so at that point, I'm just looking at him, and I'm kind of like trying to zoom out a little bit to like really look at him. And that's when that second level of love comes in, because your cosmic connection is so strong that the level of love that you experience for your partner in that space surpasses any human love that where you started from a little while before, at the beginning of this experience. So much, your hearts are so open and your connection is so deep there that it literally brings tears to your eyes as far as how intense that love space is. And so at that point, when that love just pours in, because that's centuries, that's soul stream contract, that's merged energy streams, that's the level of connection that you are becoming aware of and that you're feeling and you're sensing in this physical form that's being pulled through from other dimensions, that's unspeakable. The love is unspeakable. So that's when I've observed that that's the right place to come back into the body, pull back, and you will feel so much love for your partner that your intimate sexual experience is going to be unbelievable, unbelievable, absolutely so different than if you just took that energy and as soon as you aroused or shortly after you aroused, you just like drop right back in there and go into the physical. When you pull that level of love and that level of multidimensional connection back into your vessel with all of that awareness, with all of that shared experiences you just had, and you start bringing that and anchoring that into the physical form, your bodies would dance in that cosmic space together, and your intimate experience would cover the multiverse. And it's not necessary to know the techniques or how to do this or how to do that or how to pleasure her or how to pleasure him. All of that is irrelevant because it's the cosmic flow that's moving your bodies. And that connection, when you drop all that into the physical form, and that connection is going to give you what's called the best sex of your life. So I wanted to share this with you. This is a little bit advanced for those who want to expand and want to know each other better, more, closer, and want to know each other outside of this physical form. And also think that, or remember that your body vehicle is a storage device. It has access to all of that information. So when you guys come together, that's when all of that information is accessible to you. Take advantage of that. Take your physical intimacy to the cosmic level. I love you. If you'd like to have a session with me, you can reach me at isabellagreen.com. I do videos every week for you, every Monday and Thursday more or less. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. I cover a lot of different subjects in my videos. I love you. Take care. Namaste.